Hello, my YouTube converts. This is R. Tuzzle, the TV show guy. And on this day in 1983, back in like 36 years ago, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, I knew it. My third favorite Christmas movie came out in theaters. And to celebrate, we talk about a movie review. We're celebrating 36 years. So today we're going to talk about A Christmas Story. And yes, this is because, and yes, yeah, I've been telling you, the first one is a pretty good Christmas movie. And same as the second one, Christmas Story 2 from 2012, which that one is really good also. And to be talking about that Christmas Story is a hilarious sequel to another MGM movie besides released by Warner Brothers, which is basically titled My Summer Story, which I didn't even watch it, but I'll probably watch it in the next summer of 2020. But anywho, now onto the movie review. So it includes the 9-year-old girl, nine-year-old boy named Ralphie, who's with his younger brother named Randy. You know, Ralphie and Randy starts with R, just like my name starts with R, as in Ryan. That's my real name. You know, Ralphie has been telling in his mother all about what he was getting for Christmas is the Red Ryder rifle BB gun. And her mom was thinking like Ralphie will shoot and the eye out, cause you know, the narrator to the Christmas Story movie did sound pretty good, and yeah, always talking about that Randy could not get his arms down because he's wearing the puffy jacket in the cold winter snowy weather. You know, Ralphie is out there hanging out with his friends named Flick and the guy that I really don't know his name anymore. So and they're all going to school and talking about that Flick was going to be getting his tongue tied on on the telephone pole, and Flick was saying the word stuck, like this tongue was stuck on the telephone pole, so he keeps complaining like he is really freaking out and talking about the shields and the fire department and the cops were taking care of them. All of a sudden, Flick's tongue got burst into frostbite. And after the scene, talking about the bully. The bully boy, which I don't know his name again, and even the bully and be friends with the bully boy named Grover. The name reminds me of Sesame Street's Muppets Grover. And talking about notes that they're like rawr, and the kid's like yeah, when you know they scream and get out of here all over the place. And talking about the next scene goes on, where her mom keeps telling them to show all the piggy seeds and to Randy, and then Randy was giggling and even mom, but Ralphie smiled, except his father, of course, and possibly and all of a sudden they came knock door. They had a leg lamp. Oh, everyone out there who cares about leg lamp, just like this movie, and you. And they're talking about what he's dreaming in about. Ralphie's dreaming about something in school of, and talking about and what about the red fiber gun and Ryan A plus, and then Ralphie was been glorious and get up from a desk, and he was, and that's because Ralphie was daydreaming. So, yeah, and you know, so they're picking out a Christmas tree, and then they're going to. And then they're rocking a car, saying, and the last line on saying Jacob Bell's song, they blow raspberries instead of saying hey in the last line. And then someone got a flat tire, and then Ralphie was like, oh fudge, when he was putting his, when mom was putting soap bar in his mouth. about, you know, what's happening to Schwartz. Yeah, I think his name is Schwartz. He was talking about when Ralphie was being punished, he was laying in bed, talking about as a suits person, like, Ralphie was blind because of soap poisoning, that mom and dad and Randy was crying, which is a sad story that makes me feel angry, but oh well. And then, of course, he was going into be, I keep forgetting something, life depends. They're going to see the parade, and then they're going to see Santa at the palace mall called Huggies. And they're talking about Santa. Santa keeps saying, like, shoot your eye out, and unless Ralphie was staying long enough for Santa before the store is closing at 9 o'clock. Unless they'll be on time to set up their make up their own Christmas trees. And even though Christmas prison came and they got a Red Ryder BB gun rifle, whatever this means, you know, who's is trying to be shooting in the gun out of there, and broke the glasses on purpose. And later, all of a sudden, there is Bulldog. And he's ruining, they're knocking down their table and ruining Thanksgiving dinner, and family and the kids were so depressed. They were going to get some Chinese turkey in there, which is a big success or a surprise. That's how the ending goes. Unless it'll be a great spirits for the holidays if I can. You know, sometimes the Christmas I think that's all for the movie. I think if I'm missing something, then I'll have to watch a movie and see when it comes out, either Christmas Eve and Christmas Day on every TV schedule, not even from NBC, AMC, or Freeform, but yeah, anyways, Christmas movie, I will rate this movie a 6 out of 10, I think, because, you know, life goes on. It's my third favorite Christmas movie ever. I'm sorry that I skipped, the Christmas anniversary of Elf, but it'll be too late. I already did a late anniversary of Polar Express. Polar Express is my number one favorite. Second favorite is Elf. Even the third favorite is A Christmas Story. And my fourth favorite, possibly Home Alone 2, Lost in New York. I don't even care about Home Alone, the first film, but I will possibly look it up for the date of Home Alone 2 and then in Lost in New York, and then I'll just review it later. Sooner, I mean. Alright, well, that's all for today of the Christmas Story 36th Anniversary Special and Movie Review. But yeah, I will be deleting DVD updates of JJ and Curious George DVDs, even though I get less views again. Maybe I should have been deleting Thomas Universal and Lionsgate reprints in there. No, I don't think so. We'll see how if I should check. Watching more videos more often, and I'll have to think. Because YouTube's term of service will be updated December 10th. I don't want to lose my Google YouTube account. This is very embarrassing, I must say. Oh, well. That's all. I keep talking a lot, but I had to get back to my YouTube videos. But thank you for watching, guys, and please subscribe. Peace out, peeps.